Broadcasting from the PLA Situation Room in Roy, New Mexico, you're listening to The Snowplow Show.
Now it's time
on Prank Call Nation.
Cactus.
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 Cactus. Cactus. Cactus. Cactus.
I'm not supposed to be doing this.
Cactus.
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 Cactus, this cocksucker.
Cactus.
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 Cactus. You've got to be crapping my balls.
Cactus.
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 It's gonna be a fuck job to edit.
Cactus.
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 You're calling me a hobo.
Cactus.
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 Cactus. Roy, the retarded boy.
Cactus.
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 How about if I come down and punch your head off?
Cactus.
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 Cactus. You blowing smoke up my ass.
Cactus.
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 You think a tracer can stop me?
Hello, everybody. This is Roy. You're listening to the Snowplow Show. This is a live show, and it's sponsored by Jiad. Not Jiad, Jiad. Jiad is the sponsor of the show. When you hear me make women cry and insult people and all the other horrible things that I'll do in the show, think of Jiad and his show on the Prank Call Nation Network, The Art of Phone Larking. Thanks, Jiad, for being a sponsor. I got this email this morning from a guy who went to get his oil changed. And he told me the name of the place and where it's located, where he got his oil changed. And he says they left the computer screen up and left him in the room alone with it. And on the computer screen, he snapped a picture of it with his phone, I assume. And it's a list of customer names and phone numbers, types of car, year of their car. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13 people who are currently in the store getting their oil changed. Probably yesterday, I guess. The dates don't make any sense. But yeah, they... Oh wait, no, there's the date on the screen, but I can't read it. Oh no, it was actually this morning. It looks like it was early this morning. He was getting his oil changed. He snapped a picture of the computer screen left open with all the current customers in the store. So, I'm going to quickly call all these customers. This is just going to be like a short thing I'm doing on the air. And I'm doing this live on the air so that I can steal ideas from the chat room. Because I've done so many of these lube job things that I'm just out of ideas. I don't know. So you guys are going to feed me ideas and I'm going to steal them. Take all the credit. So here goes. First one on the list. So this first guy's name is Bill. Let's call Bill. Oh, and the quality of this picture isn't too good, so some of these numbers I might have problems with. Like this first one. I think Dust Bernadette wins the first one. He says to say, I found a can of Coke. Says, share a Coke with Brad. And I took it as an invitation to, as a date. Except this guy is not a female. So what?
Hello.
Hello, Bill?
Yes.
Hey, it's Brad from the oil change place. You got an oil change this morning?
Yeah, I got it on Friday, but how's it going?
Close enough, whatever. I saw that you left a can of Coke behind, and it says, like on the side of the Coke can, it's like, have a Coke with Brad, and that's my name. And
real? Did I leave a Coke behind?
Yeah, and it said share a Coke with Brad. You know, it had my name on the side of it. And
well, that's kind of random.
I thought it was, but I mean, I guess you're coming on to me, so I'm calling to let you know that I am available and I am interested.
Well, were you guys able to get everything, put together with the fuel man card and all that?
I don't know. I'm not the person that worked on your thing. I was just in there sweeping. But no, what I'm calling for is to set up our date.
I'm a little bit married.
Well, why would you be doing that then?
I don't. Is it the can of regular Coke?
Yeah, it's a can of Coke. You know how on the new Coke cans they say, share a Coke with? and it has a big name, and the name on this one was...
I don't drink Coke, so I don't know. So maybe I didn't leave a can of Coke.
You bought it just for me? No, we checked the security cameras, and it showed you just, you're like checking me out, looking at my ass, and then you put the Coke can down?
I don't think you're correct.
No, it's on the security camera. It's on the... And he hung up. This guy's kind of a dick, isn't he? Getting my hopes all up.
Hi, you've reached Bill. Leave me a voicemail. I'll get back to you. Thanks.
Bill. Come on, Bill. We don't have to tell your wife. It's all right. I'm very discreet. And also, I kept an important part out of your car. And if you want that important part, it's just a screw is all it is. But it's an important screw. And if you want that screw back, then you'll go out on a date with me. Basically, a screw for a screw. So, yes, please call me back. I'm really looking forward to our time together. Thanks. Thanks, Bill. Goodbye. Okay, hold on. I gotta figure out a way to organize these numbers, because this is a picture. I can't really make notes in the picture. I guess I could open it up in Paint Shop. Yeah, that's what I'll do. That's what I'll do. So this place isn't just oil changes. He was talking about something else entirely, so... I don't even understand what he was talking about. Okay. Now I've got my paintbrush. I can cross out Bill's name from this list. Wait. I don't want to use black. I want to use pink. So this computer screen, it looks, it's Windows 7, but then the program within Windows 7, it looks very, very 90s. Like, the colors and the font, it just looks really old. It looks like it's not even a Windows, it looks like it's just a DOS program inside of this window. I think that's what it is now that I look at it. Yeah, I don't think you can even click on things. There's like a menu bar at the bottom. You have to hit things like F2 and F11. O for order. They've been using this program since the 90s. Okay. Wow. A lot of ideas in the chat room. Okay. Let's call Teresa. Tell them I released lice in the car. No.
Hello?
Hi, Teresa?
Yes?
Hi, this is Dave over at the, you've got your car worked on here. It's a tire and battery place. Lube job department.
I'm sorry.
What?
What is this?
My name is Dave. I'm from the tire and battery place you brought your car in recently. Your Volkswagen.
Hi.
Wow, your phone sounds awful. What kind of...
Verizon.
Oh, man. Sounds like ass. I tampered with your car computer a little bit. I changed it around. I installed Windows 3.11 for workgroups on your car computer.
Wait, hello.
Hi, can you hear me okay? Should I call back? I'll call back. She can't hear me. I'm stealing Axpa's idea.
Sorry about that.
That's all right. I used to have shit cell phone service too, but then, you know, I decided I didn't want to sound like a, you know, stupid whenever people called me, so I got a better carrier and a better phone. So anyway, I'm Dave from the lube job department.
Okay.
And we installed Windows 3.11 for workgroups on your car computer. Like, I replaced your operating system. This one's better.
Okay. That's nice.
Yeah, it's, did you notice when you start it up, it plays MIDI files?
Well, I haven't gotten the car yet, so I...
Oh, it's still here?
No,
it's still here?
Yeah, it's still there.
Oh, thank God.
I still haven't finished making the payments on it.
That's the reason I was calling, because I left my weed in the under the seat. Like, my boss was coming, I was in your car smoking, and the boss was coming, and I shoved it under the front seat, and I thought you left with it, so I was going to see if we could arrange to get together, and I could get my weed back.
Yeah, that's fine. It's there.
Okay, yeah, I'll just get in there. I'll go ahead and smoke up again today. That was the last of my weed.
Is this a joke?
No. I thought I was out a bag of weed. But thank God it's still here. I've got to go.
Okay, they have the keys.
Okay, yeah, I got to sneak behind the counter and get the keys when they're not looking, because I'm not really allowed in the car bay section anymore ever since the incident.
Well, good luck.
What year Volkswagen is that, anyway?
It's a 2000. I actually have class, so I really have to go.
Can I take it for a spin? Like, what are they doing to it? What are they doing to it? Like, will it survive a quick drive while I smoke?
This is a joke, isn't it? Who is this?
No, it's not a joke. My name is Dave from the machine department.
Really? Because earlier you said you're from the lube department.
It's the same thing, machine lube. It's the exact same thing.
Well, I don't think it's very professional to take my car for a spin, so please leave it there.
Okay. We're going to change the car from a male car to a female car.
Okay, that's fun. Have fun with that.
Is that okay? Do I have your permission for that at least?
Yeah, that's fine.
All right.
Female power.
Yay. It's going to, your car from now on, it's going to get bitchy and pregnant. And just have an attitude with you and stuff.
Well,
it's not going to be like your old car.
Okay.
What do you haven't done to the car?
I don't know.
Maybe
you tell me.
While I'm out, I could fix it. Well, I don't know. I'm not allowed to look at the work orders anymore ever since the incident.
Right. This is hilarious. I mean, it really is, but I have to go.
What class are you taking? What's your class? What's your major? That was boring. Yeah. It's going to be emotional and completely irrational. Sorry, I didn't say that part. Okay, I'm going to cross out her name, but I'm going to use a gradient. And it's going to be a combination of white and purple. There we go. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 10 left. He already crossed out his own name. It looks like he used MS Paint or something. I'm guessing that's what he crossed out in this list. There's like white streaks through one of the customers in here. Okay, OPX. OPX. Says somebody drove away with the wrong car. With their car. But I don't know if these other people, if their cars are still here. I guess I'm going to find out on this one. This one's really hard to read, so I might have the wrong number.
Hello?
Hello, Julianne?
No, this is Nicola, his wife. Can I help you?
Well, I'm calling about his car, about his Honda. It's in the shop right now, correct?
No, not right now. We were there this morning.
Oh, and you picked it up?
Yes.
Okay, I can't use OPX's idea then. There's a small problem.
What is?
There's a small problem with the car, with the Honda.
What is the problem?
The problem is that it's a Honda Element.
Yeah, and what is the problem with the car?
No, I was just kidding about that part. I'm trying to lighten the mood because I'm embarrassed to tell you about the problem.
Why?
We switched the license plates.
What?
We took your license plates off, and we put your license... We sold your license plates to TGIF, the restaurant, and they put them on the wall. I sold them to the manager over at TGIF. His name is Buster Casey. And we put just some old plates on your car, on your Honda.
Okay, you're kidding.
I'm sorry, no. And the manager found out about it, and he's making me call to apologize. And now your plates are just novelty plates that I had printed up at a mall. Like at this kiosk. A kiosk at the mall. You know, one of those kiosks.
Yeah, sorry, I don't get it, what you're talking about.
Your license plates, they're not real, but they look real.
But the real ones are over at TGIF now, and they paid me $7 for both of them.
Okay, can you call my husband with anything?
Do I get his number?
I don't know. Maybe it's on the paper.
No, we only have this number.
Yeah, it's. I can give it to you.
Okay, don't tell me. Is it? Wait, blah, 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 blah. Don't say the area code. What's the rest of it, though?
It's 2-7.
All right. And what's his name?
Julian.
Oh, I thought you were Julian.
No, Julian is the male's name.
Is he foreign or something? That's like a weird name.
We are German.
Oh, I see. Well, you guys, you Germans have weird names. And is a Honda, is that a German car?
No, that's Japanese, I think.
You should respect your heritage. You should drive a Volkswagen or something.
Yeah, if we can afford it.
Good one. So, you don't care about the license plate thing? That's all right with you?
I just don't get it. Maybe you can just explain it to my husband, and then you can figure out what's the problem.
We sold your license plates to TGIF. Hey, that kid in the background is really getting on my nerves. Can you tell him to shut the fuck up?
Yeah. Just, okay, I'm hanging up now.
Just cover the phone and say, hey, kid, shut the fuck up.
No, I'm not.
Well, can you just make him shut the fuck up silently? Like, get his attention and then draw your finger across your throat.
No, I just, like, I told you to call my husband, and I don't know what this is about here.
Just about your license plates. What are you watching on television?
Also, er sagt mir, er hätte unsere license plate verkauft.
What? Am I on speaker now?
Yeah, you're on speaker.
You're on speaker. Do you hear me?
Oh, wait, who's that guy? Is that the husband? Now
yes.
I can hear that little...
Yes.
Hey, kid.
Kid,
kid, shut the fuck up. Hey, shut the fuck up, kid. Ma'am, how do I say shut the fuck up in German?
Okay, could you repeat what you just said?
He said shut the fuck up to our daughter. And I don't want him to talk like this to the daughter.
Well, take me off speaker then.
You are on speaker. Can you please repeat what the problem is?
Well, who's this? Is this the husband?
Yeah, yes. That's the husband.
Oh, wait, how'd you get on the phone?
Well, I'm talking to my wife through Skype right now. Could you just explain what the problem is?
Oh, that's crazy. Okay, so we sold your license plate. We sold it to TGIF, to the restaurant? On your car, when your car was here and you picked it up today?
A license plate.
This is a terrible idea. I can't hear you.
How can you sell my license plate?
TGIF buys them for $7 for a pair, and they'll put them up on the wall. Hey, kid, shut the fuck up.
Emma, kannst du bitte jetzt
mal ruhig sein? Was will er von mir? Yeah, and what are you trying to tell us now? You're claiming you sold the license plate, and now...
I couldn't hear what you just asked over that loud fucking kid.
Okay, so you're telling me you sold the license plate,
yeah.
And now...
We sold it to TGIF, to the restaurant.
Yes, and now?
And we replaced your license plate with some novelty plates.
You replaced our license plate with what?
Novelty plates.
I didn't understand that.
The plate is still there. I don't get it.
No, yeah,
you replaced the license plate by what?
But it's fake. It's a fake license plate now.
Fake license plate.
It's made out of fiberglass.
Yeah, and now what do you want us to do?
Nothing. Oh my God. I'm hanging up. I can't stand that kid anymore. Oh my gosh. I hate kids. I hate children. I still have that guy's phone number though, so I don't know what to say to him now. This is just all weird. Should I even bother calling him? I don't really know what to say to him. I already told him the joke. Okay, let me cross out their number. I'm gonna use a pattern of grass to cross out this number. Okay, I'm gonna call him.
Hello?
Hello.
Yeah,
It's Dave. Hey, I was wanting to know, do you think your Honda Element could beat me? Because I drive an Audi.
Uh-huh.
I drive an Audi. Do you think you want a street race sometime?
No, I'm not interested in a street race.
That's because you'd lose.
Probably I'd lose. Yeah, that's true. What kind of Audi do you have?
Oh, it's almost brand new. It's a 2013. I'm gonna upgrade it soon because it's too old for me.
Okay. Well, good for you. Well, we have a pretty old car. I'll probably not have a chance against
you.
So.
Yeah, Honda's a shit car. An Audi is like a Honda and a Ford put together. All in one.
A Honda and a Ford
put
together?
Yeah, put those both together and you might have an Audi.
Okay. How do you want to put a Honda and a Ford together?
I don't know. I'm not the mechanic here. I just sweep the floors here at the shop.
All right. And why are you calling me? What do you want?
Well, mainly I wanted to tell you about the license plate thing, but I wanted to challenge you to a race.
Yeah, I'm not interested in a race.
Okay.
So maybe you can explain the license plate thing again to me.
Oh, no, I was just kidding about the license plate. That was just my roundabout way of trying to challenge you to a race.
Okay.
Do you think if I called your wife back, would she race me? Would she agree to a race?
Certainly not. She doesn't even like to drive a car.
Yeah, but maybe that's because she's never raced.
You don't want to race again, so she would never do that.
Yeah. I don't know. She tried it. She might really like it. That would really get her into the whole driving thing.
Yeah, well, I know her quite well for many years, and she's not interested in that. I'm sorry.
Okay. All right, fine. All right. I guess that's all I need then.
What do you want from us?
Oh, that's all. Just to challenge you to a race. Wait. Let's up the stakes a little bit to make you interested in the race. Whoever wins, we gets the other person's wife.
How old is your wife?
My wife is 37. And she looks pretty good for 37.
Well, I'm going to hang up now because I'm not interested in that.
How old's your wife?
My wife is about the same age.
Oh, okay.
But
you're not too sure, though?
That's true.
No. All
right. If there's nothing else you want to discuss with me, then.
Well, if you're not interested, if you're not interested, why'd you ask how old my wife is?
Just out of curiosity.
Oh. How big are your wife's boobs?
I think this is not your business. So I'll hang up now.
I answered your question. So come on, you answer my question now.
Well, they're big enough. I can only give you the size in the European system. I probably won't tell you much.
Well, let's measure in hands. Handful or two handfuls or less.
Well, it's between one and two hands.
All right. Thanks for that information.
You're welcome.
All right, well, have a nice day.
All right, bye.
Tell your wife I'm sorry I told that bratty kid to shut the fuck up.
Yeah, I heard that. That wasn't very polite.
Yeah, it wasn't. I shouldn't have said that. I'm sorry.
Yeah, maybe you should apologize for that.
Do you want me to call her back? I can call her back and...
No.
I'll apologize in my own special way, and then I can challenge her to a race.
Well, you can call her up, but it doesn't have any sense because she won't talk to you.
Okay. All right. All right. Well, tell her I'm sorry and give her a hug from me.
All right. Okay.
All right.
Take care, huh?
Yeah, thanks. You too. Goodbye. That's the nicest guy ever. Wow. So far, three answers out of the three numbers I've called. That's different. Next is a male. He has an Ohio area code, even though this place isn't very close to Ohio. Silverwave wants to say that I filled the gas chamber with peanut pellets for a prank, but I did the wrong car. Wouldn't that just completely mess up their car forever? Wouldn't that make napalm or something?
Hello?
Hello, is this James?
Yeah.
I'm calling from the lube job machine department. You know, about your car, you brought your car in?
Yeah, the wheel.
Yeah, just the wheel.
Yeah.
And we got your wheel confused with someone else's wheel. Because we put the tire on, right?
Yeah, it's the right tire.
Yeah, we filled up your tire. Instead of air, we filled it up with peanut oil.
What? Peanut oil?
Yeah.
That doesn't make any sense.
Did you notice it's really heavy?
No, it's same as a regular tire.
Yeah, well, peanut oil doesn't weigh that much. But what I'm saying is, it's instead of air, like if you hit a bump really hard, it's just going to all squirt out.
I've never heard of this in my entire life, and I've worked in cars since I was like 8.
Yeah, well, you're not a professional though, right?
I feel like I'm
going
to fuck with. My dad is.
Your dad's a mechanic?
Yeah.
Oh, you should have him drain all the peanut oil out. Like, use a valve stem remover and just pull the valve stem out and just squish all the, you know, with your hands, squish the tire, so all the peanut oil.
I'm definitely getting fucked with right now.
No, I'm completely serious. It was just a
no way.
Unfortunate mistake.
I've never used anything other than calcium and oxygen to fill tires.
No, see, we keep all the tanks next to each other. Like, we have the tank for air. We have the acetylene torch tank and the peanut oil tank.
Yeah, and that's sometimes, talking about, but I've never heard of a peanut tank.
Yeah.
Peanut oil tank.
Yeah, it's peanut oil. It's very common in garages. And this jokester that works here, he switches the hoses around.
Yeah. I'm so fucking confused right now.
Can you go check it real quick? Like, just
I can.
Yeah, like,
but it's already on my car.
Yeah, well, just to make sure I have the right person, like, just pull the cap off and just, you know, kind of push your fingernail on the valve stem thing and see if it squirts out peanut oil at you. And I'll hold.
I'm going. It's going to take me a minute, though.
Okay, that's no problem.
I feel like I'm definitely getting yanked around right now.
Oh, no, we don't joke here. We're a Christian company.
Okay. It just came out air.
Oh, try it for a while, because there might be some air in there.
I don't want to empty my tire. I don't have another phone. No, it's just air.
Now just hold it down for 2 minutes, and you'll see.
Right, then my tire will be flat. I ain't doing that. I don't have a pump to pump it back up.
There'll be enough air in there to get you around.
No, because then I'll have to buy another tire, because it'll tear up the sidewall.
All right, whatever. Well, enjoy your tire filled with peanut oil.
All right.
Have a nice day.
You too.
Well, do you want to come over and, you know, kind of have it replaced?
No.
You don't care that it's filled with peanut oil?
No, not really.
Okay, I mean, it should be okay, just if you hit any bumps really hard, it's going to just
squish
burst.
Out, yeah, right.
It'll squish out the edges. And also, when you're going really fast, it might kind of seep out and get up the side of your car.
That's okay.
And peanut
My
oil.
My car needs washed anyway.
Oh, no, it's not going to wash
it'll
it.
It'll eat the paint off.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It'll eat through the paint.
Well, that's
it's like acid. But it's completely safe for, you know, rubber tires, of course.
Yeah, of course. So who called you to call me to fuck with me?
No, I'm calling from the store here that you brought your tire into.
So if I go there now, you'll be there?
Yeah, I'm here all day.
What's your name?
This is Dave.
Dave.
So you are going to come here and have it replaced?
No, I'm just checking to see if you're fucking with me.
Oh, okay. All right, well, I have to go. I have a lot of people to call here.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
That was dumb. Okay, Dr. Unk. We gotta stop doing such cartoonish things. Nobody's buying it.
Hello?
Hi, is this Robert?
Yes.
Oh, okay, great. This is Dave. I'm calling from the lube job department you brought your car in.
Oh, yeah.
And you picked that up, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I didn't see it out there in the lot anymore. Yeah, I filled up the gas tank with those plastic peanut things as a joke. I thought you were somebody else. You look just like my friend Ryan. But no, it turns out you're Robert.
Oh, I didn't even notice. I haven't filled up with gas.
Oh, okay. Yep, that's what I did. Filled up
your... Okay.
I think those things will melt, though, and they'll just turn into fuel. So you just don't... Just pretend it's not even in there.
Wait, did you put them in the gas tank?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yep. That's what I did.
Okay.
Also, I upgraded your car computer.
Uh-huh.
So this kind of makes up for what I did with the peanuts. But your car computer has been upgraded. It's running Linux now, which is a superior operating system. You had Windows in there before. Windows Millennium. Which is crazy, you know.
Yeah.
It's an O2. You shouldn't be running Millennium. You should at least have Windows 7 in there.
Okay. All right. Thanks.
Yeah. So you have Windows 3.1. Or no, I'm sorry. He's gone. I don't know where that was going. And why am I saying Windows Millennium is a operating system of O2? I was confused. I'm dumb. Dr. Unk wants me to say that I changed their AM radio to CB radio. So now they can listen to truckers.
Hello?
Hello, Liz?
Yeah, this is she.
Hey, this is Dave from the tire and lube machine department. You brought your car in here recently?
Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm doing okay.
Okay, that's good. And you picked up your car already,
how
right?
How are you?
Huh, what?
Oh, I'm doing all right. How are you?
Oh, I don't have time for small talk. You picked up your car already, right?
You know, I wasn't able to bring it in.
Oh.
I had something come up with work suddenly, and it kept me in a meeting all afternoon. So I'm really sorry I meant to call and cancel, and I just did not get the opportunity.
You bitch! That's what all this means in the computer, because we don't even have your car info written down.
Excuse me?
Like, it doesn't... Oh, my God. Can you shut that kid the fuck up? Adults are talking here.
Sorry, what business are you from?
From the lube job place.
Okay.
What kind of work did
and
you need?
And what was your name?
What kind of work did you need done on your car?
It won't be with you guys.
Why not?
Well, you just swore at me. You told me I needed to shut my kid up.
Well,
and you opened the conversation with I don't have time for small talk when I was trying to be polite to you.
I've got a lot of stuff to get through here today before we close, and I just needed to hurry up and get through this information. And your kid was being loud.
Okay, sure. Well, I don't want to keep you. I won't be coming and bringing my car to you ever, and I'll be posting a review of your website.
Oh, look at you.
Of your business.
That's so dumb. Like, nobody reads that. Nobody reads that shit anyway.
Probably not, but we'll see.
Yeah, so what's the point? Go ahead and write as many reviews as you want. Nobody's going to read them.
Non-problem.
Well, only stupid hipsters use those Yelp sites anyway.
Okay. That's fine. You won't get many business from there. So.
Okay. Yeah, we don't want those people in our business anyway.
Yeah. Great.
Because those are the type of people that just write more reviews. If you write a review, that'll keep them out, and then we'll get less reviews. So really, you're doing us a favor.
Glad I can help. I'm okay. Going to end this conversation now.
So you're going to write a review about how set up an appointment.
You have a good rest of your day.
You set up an appointment, and then you didn't even come in, and you didn't call and tell us to reschedule. You just wasted our whole day.
Yeah, I apologize for that. I got caught up in a meeting that I could not get out of.
A meeting, so. Whatever. Where'd you have a meeting at? McDonald's?
Yes, that's where I work.
Okay. Can you write in your review that your loud-ass kid won't shut the fuck up?
This conversation is over.
Is there any way I can write a review of your kid? Thanks, Sloth. Anyone named Liz is just a big jerk in my book. In my opinion. Can't stand people named Liz. They get on my nerves so much. Does she sell Amway? I should call and ask her if I can review her Avon business. Okay, we have 5 more. Minus the one that this guy that mailed this stuff to me, he crossed out. So if you're just tuning in, what happened is this guy went to get some work done on his car, and they left him alone in a room with a computer screen open that showed the names, phone numbers, make and model of every car that was currently in the shop getting worked on. So he snapped a picture and emailed it to me as soon as he got home. Like within an hour, he had this sent to me because I can read the date and time on the screen here. This is from this morning. So if you ever happen to get work done on your car and then come across an opportunity like this, I know the last two times I've brought my car in to have work done on it at the dealership here in town, they always leave me alone in a room and there's paperwork sitting on the counter. And I remember I snapped pictures of it once and sent it to either Carlito or Laugh Track Matt. But I try not to do stuff local, so I didn't do that this last time I was in there. Okay, so next. Dr. Unk really wants me to do the CB radio thing.
Hello?
Hello, Carol?
Yes.
Hey, it's Dave from the... You brought your car in to your Honda to get it worked on?
Yes.
And yes. You picked that up already, right?
Yes.
Okay, great. Did you notice what we did to the radio?
No. Did you fix it? Because there was static.
Right, yeah. Well, we upgraded it. I upgraded it myself just in my spare time because it was really slow yesterday.
Uh-huh.
Do you listen to the radio or do you mostly just stick to...
Yes, I try to when it works. It doesn't work.
Oh, I see. Yeah, we upgraded the FM band to, it's shortwave now, shortwave radio. So, it's the number, okay. The numbers aren't going to be right on it exactly. You just kind of have to guess where you are, but you can listen to stuff on the shortwave band. Like you can listen to the International Space Station. Can listen to,
oh, really?
Yeah, you can listen to your local repeaters. Listen to, air traffic in Russia. It's really cool.
Yeah, but can I listen to music?
sometimes there is music. Like, people set up pirate radio stations. It's mostly, like, mm-hmm. Linux people, and they play really crappy music.
Okay.
But there's no commercials, is a good thing.
Oh, okay.
You just have to listen to them talk about cool. Linux and crap.
Right.
And then there's your...
So what is wrong with... What happened to my radio?
Oh, who knows? I don't even care, because I just took out the FM chip, and I put in the shortwave chip. And then I tuned it all up, and it works great now. And then as far as your AM radio goes, That I adjusted that, so now it picks up CB radios.
Okay.
So if you turn on the AM band, you can tune around. Again, the numbers are going to be a little off, but you know it's channels 1 through 40 for CB radios. The truckers usually hang out on 19. The locals probably on like 14. Because there's lots of local CB radio groups here in 2014, I've heard.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. And, yeah, CB radio on AM and shortwave on FM.
Okay, so I can listen to something.
Yeah, yeah, but just not too much music, really. Music is usually frowned upon on the shortwave band.
Oh, okay.
And you do, you have I'm sorry, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Oh, you do have a ham radio license?
No.
Oh, that's, okay, don't use the FM band, because that's shortwave now, and you need a license to listen.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you can get on the internet, and just type it into Google, you know, just type in that you need your shortwave radio license.
I think I had the wrong number.
Is this Carol Torpy?
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
With the Honda Accord?
Yes.
Yeah, no, I've got the right number.
Okay. So I can't listen to shortwave, I can only listen to AM?
Right, yeah, you need a license to listen to shortwave radio.
How do they catch if you're listening to it?
It goes both ways. They'll tune in, and they'll find out if you have a license or not.
Okay, I need to just replace my radio.
Oh, no, it's cooler now, it's better now. And it's really easy to get a license. It costs just like $15 to get a license to listen to shortwave radio license. That's all you need.
Okay. Oh, okay. But, and how do I go about getting that?
What do you mean? Oh, you get on the internet and just type it into Google. I don't know the website because, you know, I've had my license for 20 years now.
Oh. Okay. But I can't listen to regular radio.
Oh, no, nothing. No music, basically.
Okay. Oh, well, thank you.
You know, if you want to listen to music, just put on your headphones. You know,
right.
Listen to your phone.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's what I do.
That's what I'll do. Yeah.
That's totally safe.
Well, thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome. And, yeah, it'll be really cool. You'll get familiar with all the radio, the CB radio traffic.
Okay. Oh, yeah. The person that's riding back with me will love that.
Yeah, it'll be lots of fun. It's so much better than AM and FM.
Okay, why, thank you.
You know, fuck commercial radio, basically. Fuck them.
It's
all about CB and amateur radio.
Yeah.
And you can transmit on it, too. You can transmit on both bands now. All you have to do is talk. It can hear you. It's voice activated. It'll hear you.
Really?
Yeah. So you're being monitored anytime you're using the radio now because they can hear things you say. You can talk back to them. So it's really cool. It's really futuristic.
Why, thank you.
Sure.
I'll let you know how that goes.
Okay. Also, I left I left some stuff under your seat.
Okay. What's that?
Are you coming back for any other work? Because maybe you could just give it to me when you're here.
Oh, did you leave something accidentally there?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm leaving tomorrow at noon, so I'll try to stop by and drop it off.
And you don't have to look to see what it is, okay? Just pull up and just I'll see you coming and I'll run in and grab it while you turn your head and don't look at what it is.
Oh, certainly.
Okay, thanks. You're so accommodating.
I'm sorry, you forgot to put to. I'm sorry you left it there.
Oh no, you don't have to apologize. It's not completely your fault. But I appreciate the apology. I appreciate the gesture. You're not going to look, are you?
Well, No, I promise I won't look.
Okay, thanks. Thank you.
You're welcome, Dave. I'll see you tomorrow.
All right, see you then.
Okay, take care.
You too. Goodbye. Enjoy your radio. Bye.
Thank you.
Just hang up now. That was weird. Are you happy, Unk? That prank call was brought to you by Dr. Unk and Sloth. Okay, Dr. Unk. Dr. Unks wants me to say that the blinkers, we switched them on the car. So left is right and right is left. And also, I should tell them that we reversed the headlights with the brake lights. So if they want the headlights on, they have to hit the brakes. And then, you know, to push the brakes, you just kind of flick the headlight switch a few times. Okay, so, This guy's not going to believe that. His name's DJ. Nobody named DJ would believe something like that.
Hello?
Hello, DJ?
Yes.
I'm calling from the car place. You got your, you brought your Ford pickup in?
Yes.
And you did pick that up already, right?
Yes.
Okay, that's good. There's a small problem.
Uh-huh.
We were messing around with your lights on the back, your blinkers.
Okay.
And we reversed, like, we do this as a prank, you know, to the people that work in the...
The what?
We reversed your blinkers. So if you want to turn left, you need to turn on the right blinker. And if you want to turn right, you need to turn on the left blinker.
Okay.
Yeah, and it's just going to be like that from now on.
Uh-huh.
Yep, and I'm really sorry about that. I thought the guy that was working on your car, I thought he would notice and he would fix it, but he didn't even notice. It was just supposed to be a prank.
Okay.
So can you can you remember that?
Yeah.
Okay, repeat what I said. What do you have to do from now on? DJ just hung up on me.
Hello?
I just want to make sure you understand what we did to the blinkers.
Who is this?
My name is Dave. I work here at the garage.
Where at?
At the place where you brought your Ford in.
Yeah.
Don't you believe me? He's not buying it. Okay, the next guy will believe me. Oh, the next one is a female, so she'll definitely believe me, because females don't know anything about cars, you know? They just, you know, if it's not a blender or a toaster or a food processor, they're just like, dur, 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 dur. What's this?
I'm sorry, but the person you called has a voicemail.
This next guy's name is Brad. What a dumb name. His number is hard to read, so this might be a wrong number again.
Hello?
Hello, is this Brad?
Yes.
Hey, this is Dave. I'm calling from the car place you were going to bring in your car to have it worked on.
Yeah.
And you haven't brought that in yet, have you?
No, I take it in on Friday.
Oh, okay. And what exactly did you need done to it?
I'm getting tires put on.
Oh, just four new tires?
Yeah, four new tires.
Okay, all right. I think we can handle that. I guess. Yep, probably. I would imagine.
Is this?
Oh, my name is Dave. Calling from the garage.
Okay.
Do you have any objection to a female working on your car?
No.
Okay. She doesn't really know a lot about cars. But we're going to let her just go solo at it. We're going to let her have at it. Say, do your best. So, can't really make any guarantees, but I think she'll do okay. She's never changed a tire before on her own. I mean, she's seen it done lots of times here. She's usually just the she usually just runs the computer.
This is a weird call. Why?
What's weird about it? Like, do you have a problem with females working in your car? On your car?
No, I have a... This is just... This doesn't make any sense.
We have to let
Who is this, really?
She's trying to open up a lawsuit or something, saying we're not equal opportunity. Because up until now, we've just had her, you know, working at the front desk and getting me coffee and stuff like that. So now I have to let her do car work to show that I'm not sexist.
This is a weird call.
I don't see what's weird about it. I think she'll be fine, though. Like, I think she'll be able to do it.
Yeah, I don't think that's a good idea.
Why? Are you sexist? You don't think girls should work outside of the kitchen?
I'm pretty sure I'm going to hang up now. Thank you.
She's going to wear a tight skirt while she does it. So, even if she fucks it up, it'll be awesome. I noticed, like, right as it connected, I noticed he hadn't brought his car in yet. So I was just, dur. I didn't know what to say. The next one hasn't brought her car in yet either, and I've finally understand how to read the dates on these things. This person is bringing in their car on Saturday. It's a female. Her name's Laura. She's not brought her car in yet, but she's bringing it in on Saturday. It doesn't say what for, though. So, I guess I need help. What should I say to somebody who hasn't brought their car in yet, but they will be bringing it on Saturday? Also, is Jag TV supposed to start doing a show soon? Because I don't want to steal his... Let me ask him. Because I think the purge is today, and I know it kind of starts early-ish, so I might be cutting into his time right now. Which is fine, because I only have one more number. Yeah, why am I even asking? I'm almost done. This is the last number I'm doing. Laura, Dr. Unk wants me to tell Laura that it's take your cat to work day on Friday. Or maybe he's just talking about his life. I don't know. Oh, that's a good one. Do what now? Says a woman must be accompanied by a man. Okay, I'll do that. I'll do that.
Hello?
Hello, Laura?
Yes.
Hi, this is Dave. I'm calling from the garage you're bringing your car in this weekend.
Oh, yes. Hi.
And you're still bringing that in this weekend then?
I was going to go at 1:30.
Okay, yeah, that sounds good. And are you going to be bringing a man with you?
I'm going to be bringing a man with me?
Yeah.
I don't think so. Why?
Oh, no, well, you have to. It's kind of a policy here. Because, you know, women, they don't know anything about cars, and we need to bring a man in. To sign the paperwork.
Who is this?
This is Dave from the garage.
Uh-huh, and your last name, Dave?
McDaverson?
Uh-huh. Thanks, Dave.
And what? Are you going to bring a man with you then? She's not buying it. Tons of thanks goes out to the guy that sent this to me. Brought his car in and decided to snap me a picture. That was awesome. I'm about to quit. I just talked to Jag TV on Skype, and he says, yes, he is doing a show tonight, and he won't tell me what time. He says I should do another 30 minutes, though, so I'm guessing he's coming to do a show here in about 30 minutes from right now, so I'm not going to stay here for 30 minutes. I have shit to do. But everyone should continue listening to the Mixer stream, the PCN stream. Wait for Jag TV to come on.
Hello. We're the bad guys, and we cover you in cacti's. Backflip off the phone bridge, that's suicide.